Sipo is here, and Shedo is here from Alexandra. I was born at 68 10th Avenue in Alexandra. You can guess my age. I was born 68 on the 27th of January. You can guess my age. In those numbers, you can guess my age. Ladies and gentlemen, I hardly ever start an address with a focus on myself. Today is, however, different. January is a special month for me. It is my personal year end. It is in January that I reflect on the year that was for me and look forward to my year ahead. Today is the beginning of my personal year. It was on this day, many moons ago, that I was born. I therefore feel doubly blessed that this great recognition by the Johannesburg Stock Exchange is happening on my birthday. I would like to thank Johannesburg Stock Exchange Chairman or Chairperson Nonkululeko Nyembezi Nyeita, the CEO Nikki Newton Kingent, and the entire board of directors for finding our contribution to football befitting of Johannesburg Stock Exchange recognition. The three of us, Kaizer, Jomo, and I, are born and bred in Johannesburg. We've got one thing in common. We're all Buccaneers. I would have naturally said Johannesburg boys, but I think we are past that sell-by date. We have, as a result, watched, even though it was from a distance at times, the impressive development of this great institution. We have managed to keep South Africa plugged into the world of financial markets and our rand, a terrible currency. Countries with security exchanges that are transparent and trustworthy are best placed for investment, as their security exchanges facilitate one of the key requirements of a safe investment, namely exit. When I evaluate investment opportunities, I question my ability to exit safely before I question with how much. Johannesburg Stock Exchange is therefore an invaluable national asset whose credibility we should safeguard. It is my wish that you succeed not only in being a credible exchange for investment houses and high-wealth individuals, but that you manage to get middle-class Joe Soap and Africa Maibuya to trade securities. This will plug them into our economy in ways that will improve their productivities and daily lives. The best place to start is schools. There is nothing that beats the ills that plague society like ignorance, disease, and famine than education and socialization. I am prepared to work with the Johannesburg Exchange using this rich frequency and appeal of football to socialize and educate future generations to become retail investors with the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. The business of football is a business of passion. It is socialized very early in our supporters' lives. Support for football clubs provides supporters with an unmatched sense of belonging. When supporters talk of their clubs, they use the word we. Jomo Cosmos supporters are this week saying, "We beat Orlando Pirates over the weekend." I thought I would get that out of my way, much more to the pleasure of Jomo Sono. He seems to be determined to use defeating Orlando Pirates to boost the morale of his team, both players and supporters, the way Mr. Motaung. I'm bracketed this weekend. Is Jomo this side? Is Kaizer this side? But I'm your father, both the same. I've got the shoulders big enough to absorb the pressure. Football is attractive because it is a civilized resemblance of war. It employs the tactics and formations of war. There is seven war talk fueled by commentators inciting coaches and supporters to participate in name calling that get opposing team temperatures up. This Saturday is the day of one of the most well-recognized derbies. The talk time and column inches dedicated to Orlando Pirates versus Kaizer Chiefs and counters are unmatched for a sporting event in our country. It is one of the most prayed for events in the millions of peer groups around the country. Its following knows no boundaries. It transcends race, gender, age, religion, and strata. It is one conversation that the CEOs and male dispatchers have with equal knowledge and passion. It provides the best opportunity for inclusive bonding that is essential in setting where we need to bring individuals with such diversity as we have in our country to work towards common goals and values. Ladies and gentlemen, today is emotional for me that these two gentlemen sitting here, we've been doing great things for this country unnoticed, and that's why I want to thank the Stock Exchange for recognizing the contribution that we have made. That, you know, at one point, when I became a forcible, what's called administrator at a young age, I conceived an idea of playing a testimonial game for Jomo Sono. And the Kaizer phoned me to say, let's do it together. Because I think I've got three or five of my other players, Sylvester Cole, Tine Zlada, Isin Twelengi. When you play the testimonial game, which generated a lot of money in those years. And that was one of the most important starting points of what is the meaning of cooperation. And that game was important because it was a precursor of what we know as the Iwisa Spectacular. But more importantly, just that same year, Jomo Sono was involved as among members of the task team that was to participate in the reposition of South African football in this country, to give birth or what you call now today the National Soccer League. In that committee, where it will take on the might of George Tabe to transform football, to extricate or see the value of football. Because at that particular time, the business of football, nobody understood it. So he was part of that committee, together with Raymond Hegg and Bamji, that gave rise, you know, to what we see as the PSI. But more importantly, Kaizer was also the one that organizing all the clubs to see this vision, that, you know, football must go a different direction. It was difficult to sensitize the teams to go against George Tabe. And I'm happy that this project became a success. It was a defining era, a defining moment in the history of football in this country. Today you get what is SAFA. SAFA is born out of that most important decision that was taken by clubs where we signed that agreement at Carlton Hotel at 2 o'clock. But more importantly, as the brewery said that, you know, if Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs are not part of this initiative, we're not going to sponsor the National Soccer League. And I'm happy that we did exactly that, what we see today. But more importantly, these three gentlemen were involved in the formation of the National Soccer League, were in the executive committee of the National Soccer League. We achieved great things together, great things with Jomo Sono in business beyond that point. But there's one moment I want to capture, ladies and gentlemen. Kaizer Motaung is a very modest, quiet man. But when you sign the most important deal that is now 10 years, today we're 30 years as a PSL. It's quite remarkable that I'm honored on the year that we're 30 years as a PSL. Now, we are 10 years with multi-choice, or what you call a super sport, having signed the most important broadcast deal in the history. In that broadcast deal, it was memorable because never in the history of Africa, on some continents in Europe, that deal was ever struck. But for the first time, knowing Kaizer Motaung, because of his modesty, because he's quiet, after quietly making my way how much the deal involves, Kaizer, for the first time, it was the first and last time, he gave me a hug. But before he did that, he looked this side, he looked that side, there was nobody. And he gave me a hug. And I could see the emotion in his eyes that what we started in 1985 is a most important crusade to transform the world of football. That is mission accomplished. So looking back, we'll say whatever happens, we have made our contribution. Thank you, Stock Exchange, for recognizing that. To conclude, on a beautiful summer autumn Tuesday in Pretoria, 10th May 1994, when Nelson Mandela was inaugurated as the first and all-inclusive democratic, non-racial, non-sexist president of our beloved country, South Africa. He did not give a long speech. In fact, he spoke for exactly 9 minutes and 12 seconds. His speech contained only 90 words. Most of his speech was befittingly made up of gratitude as he expressed how beautiful and thankful, appreciative and grateful he and the people of South Africa were to all those around the world who found the cause of our freedom a cause worthy of their support. The balance of Madiba's speech is a promise to the world and a challenge to us, his countrymen and women. It challenges us to build out of an extraordinary human disaster that was apartheid, a society all humanity will be proud of. It urges all South Africans in our ordinary daily deeds to produce an actual South Africa reality that will reinforce humanity's belief in justice, strengthen its confidence in the ability of the human soul, and sustain all our heroes and hopes for a glorious life for all. The time to build is upon us, he quote. We understand still that there is no easy way to freedom. We know it well that none of us acting alone can achieve success. We must therefore act together as a united people for national reconciliation, for nation building, for the birth of a new world, close quote. Ladies and gentlemen, it is perhaps my deepest closing words to his inauguration speech, the words he mentioned before he said, God bless Africa. These words should never, ever be lost to any South African ever, especially its leaders, in whatever sphere of our society they lead. Madiba said, I quote, the sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement, close quote. Notice that Madiba did not say, the sun should never set, which would have expressed his wish and plea to us. Instead, made an irrevocable commitment, the sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Ladies and gentlemen, I call this the privilege of being cut from the same cloth with Nelson Mandela. We South Africans of all races, sexes, and ages and faiths are privileged in that we are all cut from Mandela's own cloth. It sets us above the rest. This privilege requires an irrevocable commitment from all of us in our daily deeds to embody and live our lives towards the fulfillment of my deepest irrevocable dream. Ladies and gentlemen, lastly, I want to thank my family that without your support, I wouldn't have achieved what I've achieved in my life. At some point, I was nearly killed at the Orlando Pirates Football Club, and I refused to go back. But because of pressure, because I saw the beauty, the power of the brand of Orlando Pirates, the contribution of these two gentlemen and other translators of this team, that we've got to protect this history. Today, Orlando Pirates is one of the pillars of football in this country, and I'm sure you'll be happy that people are recognizing that your home is not a mkuku. Your home is a proper home. Thank my family. Thank you, gentlemen, for your support and contribution in football. God bless the Stock Exchange. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for those kind and wise words. I would like to call upon Tate Motaung. Maybe I might get a hug. No 10-year deal. Just a bit of caution. As the same way as soccer is also a rolling ball, things change. We might have to stop you like 2 minutes before 9 o'clock because the market does not wait for anybody. So we'd like to do some quick presentation on how to read the screens on the stock market, and then from there we'll go into opening the stock market, and then we'll continue with hearing those wise words from you.
Thank you very much. The advantage of speaking after the chairman is that you don't have much ground to cover. In fact, you have no ground to cover because he has said it all. But let me take this opportunity to first and foremost thank the JSE board for the invitation here today. It is indeed a special day, as already been mentioned, but for me in particular, it's special in that it takes me back memory lane, where as a youngster growing up in Soweto, it dawned on me that after my school days, there is going to be a journey to undertake. And in this regard, my first full-time job after I left school was at the stock exchange. I worked for a stockbroker. The name of the firm was Max Pollock and Fremantle. And it was at the old stock exchange at Hollard Street. And this is where I was exposed to the ongoings in the stock exchange, and I was privileged to be at a very early age, understand what's going on there. So it actually gave me a very good start in terms of the lessons I learned in terms of the work ethic and so forth. Although I didn't work for very long, as you know, there came a time where I had to make a decision to say which career path do I pursue. And when it became clear that having sacrificed my schooling, I will not go into the reasons why I left unexpectedly at school at the time, because I was in trouble with my parents. I then realized that to pursue a lifetime career needs commitment. And I was so glued to this beautiful game of football to the extent that I was blind, and I just wanted to move forward, and I wanted to go ahead, and I did get a break and went overseas and learned quite a lot there. And of course, the rest is history. But coming back to to this day today, I would like to thank the board of the JSE for the recognition and the honor bestowed upon us here today. A lot of people do not realize the impact of football in terms of the socio-economic needs of our communities, what football contributes in that regard. I can quote a lot of areas in terms of the GDP, what we contribute towards the GDP. In fact, recently in the PSL, we commissioned an economic impact study just to see what football contributes towards the economy of the country. And the results were very much incredible, very interesting, to see that football plays a very, very critical part in terms of the economy. So I would like to thank once more the board of the JSE for this recognition, but also would like to thank my colleagues here for the journey we undertook and the commitment we made. And I can guarantee you, they will also attest to what I believe was driving me to do whatever I did. We did pursue our goals purely on the basis of building the industry of football and developing the sport of football. Little did we know in the beginning when we started that we are bound to, excuse me, I have to pause a little bit because of the stock exchange.
it's that time. What we're going to do is that we're going to open the market. We'll do a countdown as from now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Make noise, make noise. That was the market opened by our fathers of soccer in South Africa, 2016. Ndate Motaung, you may resume your speech. Sorry about that, it was not me, it's the market.
I was commending my colleagues for the contributions that we made in terms of taking football where it was at the time, even to bring it here today, the sacrifices that we made during those days. For us, in a nutshell, looking back, we can say we did it against all odds. We had a problem in our country, we all know. We didn't have the same kind of opportunities and privileges. And therefore, it was difficult. We went through difficult times. But today, I think we can all feel proud that when we do exit the space, we are going to be leaving a very good legacy. So I would like to congratulate my colleagues for their contributions as well, and all other people who are not here, those of us who are still around, and those obviously who passed on, because this football journey has been eventful and very exciting. So once more, thank you to the JSE board for the recognition. And of course, in closing, I would like to wish Mr. Dr. Khoza a happy birthday. I think we do know how old you are. And we also know that you come from a dusty street in Alexander. But I think today we can all thank God that he gave us the blessings to have achieved what we have achieved. And I also thank my family as well. My parents gave me all the support that I needed at the time when I was still young, taking on big challenges. When I look back, sometimes I think, how did I have where did I get the energy to do some of the things I did? And I can only thank God. And of course, all the other members of the family and the larger member of the Kaizer Chiefs family, the larger family of the soccer fraternity as a whole. It is quite interesting that last week Dr. Khoza and Jomo were locking horns, and this week it's Chiefs and Pirates again. So I think we need to repeat what Jomo did last week. Just to do justice to this cause, because I don't think it will be good for to let Pirates, spoil the whole thing. Well, the father has to sacrifice, so this is your time to take the knock once more. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here, and of course, thanks to the Johannesburg Stock Exchange.
Thank you for those wise words. And quite interesting that you have actually been in the industry. We don't know why you ran away, but it's fine. You made a good career in the soccer fraternity. A disclaimer from the JSE, we cannot comment on what happens with the games, who's going to win, and so on. We are the exchange. We need to be very neutral. Ntate Sono, may I call you to the stage to address us.
Program Director, first and foremost, I'd like to thank the JSE for the honor bestowed on the three of us. I think we deserve it. But my only concern with the JSE and the board, what I was not happy about was the JSE has told Kaizer and myself that they support Pirates. Look at the colors. You know, so I would like to say to Kaizer, unfortunately, I would like to support you for the weekend. But, you know, it's a bit of a problem for me because I've just beaten my father and you're also going to beat your father. So in our culture, both of us can't beat the father the same weekend. So a draw will be okay. And it's good that I beat Paris. I feel good. You know, just to go back a bit, as you know, we've been footballers all our life. And I grew up at Orlando East, and JSE is all about Inyogu. Me, when I came here, I thought, hey, I'm going to get some money at JSE. The only thing I got there was cold drink and juice. And, but just to go back, you know, I used to sell apples and peanuts just to get my education going through. But as Kaizer said, I was also crazy about football. I just wanted to play football and football and football. But I grew up working with money. As I grew up, I started selling players. You know, I never knew that I'll end up here in the monies. But my highlight of my career was one year we went to Italy with Dr. Khoza. We jointly owned the Markfish. I was smart, I was clever. When I sold Markfish to Pirates, I said, no, I'll retain 50% of Markfish. Can you imagine retaining 50% of a human being? I said, no, I'll retain Markfish 50%. We negotiated for a long time with Dr. Khoza. In the end, he saw that he can't break me, so we ended up agreeing. So Markfish played, became a household name. He signed with an agent, and Markfish became a big player, and Juventus, Lazio, wanted to buy Markfish. And the agent came, and I said, no. When you talk about Markfish, you don't talk to Dr. Khoza alone. I have to sit there and listen and hear, because now we're talking of dollars or euro. So they called me to a meeting, and I sat there and I listened. And then they said, okay, now we have to fly to Italy. So we're sitting in different seats in the plane with Dr. Khoza, and we flew to Italy. And when we go to Italy, we find that Markfish, a deal was being done behind our backs by the agent. So, you know, Dr. Khoza, you know, he's trouble, you know. So he calls me, says, come, let's go there. And he says to me, he points a finger at me, he says, he speaks in Zulu, he says, ngifuna ungilalele kahle. Masifika lapha, you become a very good guy. Me, I become a bad guy. And that time we needed the money. So we went, sat in the board, Dino Zoff, who was one of the top goalkeepers, comes along, and the agent comes. Hey, they started talking, you know, money, 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 money. Hey, me, I'm in another world. I'm used to selling players with 1,000 rand, 2,000 rand here in South Africa. Now I hear them talking about $5 million. I said, oh my God, I'm in the right spot here. If God can ask me again what you want to do in your next life, I'll say, no, I want to back soccer because I can sell another Mackfish. So we sat there, and I can tell you, ladies and gentlemen, for me, it was the first time I sit in a room where people were negotiating. It was unbelievable. Dr. Khoza was unreal, and me, I was a nice guy. And I kept saying, no, man, don't get upset, Mr. Khoza. And he says to me in Zulu, kubeka lokhu ngikhuza wena. So we reached a deadlock where we couldn't agree. And he hits me with a knee and he says, ungivimbe emnyango mangiphume. So he stands up. He says, I cannot stand this. I'm going. So when he turned, he says, ungakhohlwa. He walked. He was worried of the money, you know, because if he goes, maybe they'll say the deal is off. So he says to me, don't forget to stop me before I get to the door. So I'm sitting there, I said to them, you see now, the chairman is upset. You upset the chairman. Wait. And I sprinted. But he's walking very, very slow. Because he wants me to catch him before he gets to the door. So I bring him back. And he goes, No, I don't want to talk to these people. They think we're selling monkeys from Africa. I don't want to talk to these people. I said, okay, Dr. Khoza. Put him on a chair and I went and I got water for him and I told him, I said, please, gentlemen, let's agree on the fee. Please. Because now, if he walks out now, he's going to walk out forever and you will lose a player. So the Italians went out. They said, excuse us. They came out. They came back. They agree on the fee. Now he has forgotten that he needs to sit now. He still walks out, but they have agreed. So I say to him, where are you going? He says, I'm going to the loo. So I follow him to the loo. He says, well done, we got the money. So the negotiation skills, you know, I pick up some of them from him. Because, as you know, I sold a lot of players in South Africa, but it was mainly rents, you know. So I would like to say to Mr. Motaung and Dr. Khoza, as they said, we've come a long way. You know, people see us on TV, on radio, fighting, thinking that we're fighting. We're not fighting. We want you to come. The more we fight, the more you people come to the stadium. Look at the crowd we had at Potchefstroom, because they think I'm fighting pirates. No, if you meet us in meetings, you won't go out, because we spend hours and hours just jokes and laughing all the time. It's just jokes. Some of the meetings at PSL used to take 1 hour, 2 hours. We're just talking about stories. So I would like to thank JSE for honoring this three gentlemen. I think you deserve it, especially where we come from. Sometimes it was life-threatening. We took a risk, all of us. We were prepared even if to die for the sake of football. And for me, as you can see, even the speech was done in order, order of the age, you know. even the sitting there, it's order of the age, you know. We go this way and then down to the youngest buccaneer, you know. I'm still a buccaneer at heart, you know. It never changes. I'll always be a buccaneer, and I think Mr. Motaung feels the same, because you cannot neglect your dad, no matter, even if you get married and leave, you still think of Ekhaya, Orlando East, and I would like to thank them for the support as well, you know, because I'm the youngest of the trio, and I'm the youngest of the trio as a Buccaneer. And Lastly, I would like to thank my family. My wife, she's not feeling well. She's down with flu. For their support, because without a family, you are nothing. The family is your spine. Also, the supporters at Cosmos. And also, not to forget, the people who are running the PSL, you know, they go through a lot of troubles. You know, Professor Schloss has been here for years and years. I think very soon the chairman will have to give you a watch. You've been here, Derek Blankensee, the staff. They go through hell from us, the clubs, especially when you lose a game. We always have something to say. But this weekend was different. I won, I had something to say. So I'm different. I would like to thank again all the people who made it possible, and also the people who came here so early in the morning. And it will be good for us and the players to start learning about JSE, because some of us didn't know anything about JSE, not referring to me. My JSE was Dr. Khoza in Italy, so I know about money. But thank you very much once more for the honor. Thank you.
Yeah, a special day at the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. The big three in South African soccer being honored there.
And now there's a song. Okay. Thank you very much for those kind words. I've learned something, and mostly I think all of us have learned something, that it is not a fight, it's a good fight. So we shall be glued to the screen to see what actually happens. So we welcome also the invitation to actually work with the players, to help them learn and understand the stock market, because you need to understand before you start putting your money in. For that, we will have our first lesson today. It's going to be 2 minutes, and essentially we'll have that day James to come and just give us a rundown in terms of what you're seeing up there. It's lots of numbers, but it will all make sense just now.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is James Rakumako, and I'm part of the trading team that manages the trading engine. The screen to my right there is the market data front end, which is sponsored by Iris. At the top of the screen, you can see the equity market ticker. At the moment, it's filtering through trades that have been active on the stock market. The JSE operates an order-driven central order book trading system with an opening, intraday, and closing auction call sessions. Automated matching occurs during the continuous trading session, which is between 9 and 5 o'clock. Below the equity market ticker, it's the ticker for the derivatives market, where you can see what is called the Aussie spot, which tracks the overall index. The derivative market opens at 8:30. The gray area towards the middle of the screen, as you can see there, it's the trading formation for the JSE share. I just saw the graph there, so it's gray before the market opens. And at the top there of the screen as well, you can see where it says security JSE. That's how brokers identify the stock JSE. If it was MTN, it will say MTN or Vodacom VOD. And then the ISIN code, ZA is for South Africa, to let you know that this stock's primary listing is in South Africa with its unique code as well. Opening, it's the opening price. As you see, it's 12200. That's in cents. That's where the JSE share opened this morning. Bid refers to buy, and ask refers to sell. And last will be the last price this share has traded on. And high is obviously the highest price so far this morning, and low is the lowest price. M price, M vol at zero at the moment. This is only active before the market opens, because it indicates where the share will likely open. The market volume, market valuation, and trades as well will keep on updating as trades go on throughout the day. Then towards the left of the screen, you can see the order book for the JSE share. On the far left, where you see volume 145 and price, that's the bid side, and the other side will be the ask side. And furthermore, to the right on the trades, that's all the trades that have occurred at the moment on the JSE. And at the bottom graph there, that is the graph for the all-share index, which tracks the all-share index performance for the last 12 months. And as you can see, it's been up and down over the last 12 months, and we are very low at the moment. We have both local and dual listed stocks trading on the JSE, and currently we have over 895 listed instruments that are active for trading on the equity market. Thank you very much.
That was our first crash course in terms of what we'll be going through. The other formal learning will be in the classroom, which is this side. I think we come into the close of the proceedings right now. First of all, we want to acknowledge and thank you, gentlemen. We'd like to acknowledge and thank the family members who are here. We know that they are sacrificing a lot to what you are contributing towards this country. And we also like to thank you for actually adhering to our invitation, which was very kind of us to actually invite you. And we look forward to getting more involved with SOCA in terms of getting more people to understand about the JSE. This is an opportunity for us to get to know as well as invest in the economy of our country. For that, now we would like to do some formal pictures, and I will call our CEO, Nyukinitin King, to actually do the pictures with the gentleman. Yes. Sorry. We also have some gifts for you. These are really wonderful sculptures. The sculptures are made to represent the two animals that most probably we use in the market, which is the bull and bear. It is the replica of what we have as the statue outside the building. And we hope that the gentleman will enjoy that. Thank you very much. When we're done with the pictures, we will start with breakfast. We will encourage our guests to start first, and then we family shareholders, we will eat afterwards. And then from there, we can actually just mingle around and chat. Thank you.